Now let's discuss these late-breaking developments with the former Homeland Security Secretary Jeh Johnson that served during the Obama administration. Mr. Secretary, thanks so much for joining us. As you can see and as you sense yourself, Americans are on edge right now. What's your take? What's your reaction when you see this new fencing going up around the entire White House grounds? You see all these stores, these businesses boarding up, not only in the nation's capital, but in so many cities around the country right now. The fear of disturbances, irrespective of who wins this election.
Wolf, I don't like what I see. I was responsible for the security of the White House compound when I was Secretary of Homeland Security. The sight of businesses boarding up their windows across America, it's unnerving. I don't like what I see. I cannot discount the possibility of unrest, on violence on Election Day, in the aftermath of Election Day. And so I suspect that over the coming days, when roughly one half of America is going to be very, very unhappy with the election result and tensions are running high, that we're going to have to count on our nation's leaders, Republicans and Democrats, to help bring the temperature down. To tell people that there are things more important than the outcome of a particular election for 4 years, for a four-year period. And so I cannot discount the possibility of civil unrest here. It's very troubling to see this, but all Americans should realize that there are things more important than the outcome of a single election, the preservation of our democracy, our public safety. And I hope that those with a public voice can be counted on to help bring the temperature down. Unfortunately, we have not seen that from our president in the last 4 years.
Walk us through the decision-making process. You were the Secretary of Homeland Security. How does that unfold, a decision to put a huge fence now around the White House on the eve of a presidential election? I've never seen that before a presidential election. I don't know if you have, but it's pretty extraordinary.
I've never seen anything like that. And in fact, in my experience, this is about as high as emotions can run just before a presidential election. My educated guess is that the Secret Service, those in Homeland Security, those in law enforcement are looking at law enforcement sensitive reports about possible civil unrest and are taking adequate precautions. The White House compound in ordinary circumstances is the most secure building in America. For the Secret Service to take this added step is quite significant in my view.
And we do know the president will be at the White House tomorrow night. He'll be watching the election results. They will have a reception for supporters in the White House tomorrow night as well. So they want to make sure everything is secure. In a situation like this, you got to err on the side of caution, obviously, because everyone is so nervous. But it's so critically important as the results come in, Mr. Secretary, for the leaders of this country, Republicans and Democrats, everyone, to tell the country, you know what, this is democracy, this is an election, let's see what happens, calm down.
Yes, that's my point. Elections, state by state, are rarely certified on the night of the election. They're rarely formally called by state election officials. You folks in the networks have developed very, very sophisticated means for projecting the winner of an election. And I remember well, Wolf, in November 2008, you projected Barack Obama was going to be the president of the United States. That was a call made by the networks. That was not the final tally. And so I suspect that this may be a very close election, and we may have to wait for a number of days. And during that period, you're right, it's incumbent upon those of us with a public voice, Republicans and Democrats, to work to bring the temperature down, to bring the anxiety down until we get a final result. We're used to peaceful transitions of power in this free democracy, and I hope that this year is not an exception.
The the president had this to say earlier about Pennsylvania, which is going to be counting ballots that arrive within 3 days after Election Day, even if they were postmarked before Election Day. But I want you to listen to what the president had to say. It's very disturbing.
And when the Supreme Court gave you an extension, they made a very dangerous situation, and I mean dangerous, physically dangerous, and they made it a very, very bad, they did a very bad thing for this state. They did a very bad thing for this nation. You have to have a date. You can't extend dates. The danger that could be caused by that extension, and especially when you know what goes on in Philadelphia, and it's been going on for years. So, Governor, open up your state, and please don't cheat, Governor. Please don't cheat. Because we're all watching. We're all watching you, Governor. We have a lot of eyes on the governor and his friends. A couple of other governors out there, too.
So what's your reaction when the president levels what clearly sounds like a threat to Governor Wolf of Pennsylvania?
Wolf, I'll repeat what I've said before. People do listen to their leaders, particularly the president. A downward spiral in rhetoric makes the previously intolerable tolerable. And for the deranged, dangerous people who live among us, violence inevitable. We got a taste of that in Michigan. Fortunately, through the good work of law enforcement, state and federal, that conspiracy was stopped in its tracks. People do listen to their leaders, which is why those with a microphone, particularly the president, need to be responsible in their rhetoric. There could be dangerous consequences if someone with a bullhorn the size of what President Trump has is not responsible.
Yeah, he says we should stop counting ballots on Tuesday, tomorrow night. After that, we shouldn't count anymore. But we've always counted ballots after the Tuesday of Election Day. You were the general counsel at the Department of Defense. You know, military ballots from hundreds of thousands of troops around the world, they always come in late and they're always counted.
Wolf, my son wears the uniform of our nation. He cast a ballot from overseas. I want my son's vote counted. He's a patriotic American who is serving our country like many others who wear the uniform of this nation. They deserve to have their votes counted. If someone is qualified to vote, someone votes on time, if someone sends in a ballot that is postmarked on or before Election Day, they deserve to have their votes counted. I cannot imagine a reason why someone would want to stop the counting of votes from those who are qualified to vote and who have voted.
Yeah, that's what the president is saying, and it's outrageous, I must say. Jeh Johnson, the former Secretary of Homeland Security, thanks so much for joining us.